All right, Mr. D, let's talk a little bit about lawn chemicals, and let's start with the Phenoxy herbicides. 2,4-D is one of those.
2,4-D is one of them. The benzoic acids, dicamba is another Phenoxy herbicide. Right. Been around for a long time. Phenoxy herbicides have been around since 1946,
a long time.
Believe it or not. Best known ones are 2,4-D, 2,4-5-T is another well-known one. A few years ago, you don't hear much about that anymore. Mm-hmm. A combination of 2,4-D and 2,4-5-T made up a material called Agent Orange, which was used back in the Vietnam War. Mm-hmm. Great product for 2,4-5-T is really good on killing woody ornamentals. Used it extensively in Texas to control mesquite in pastures and doesn't hurt grasses. Okay. But there was a problem with dioxin, and 2,4-5-T is off the market now because of that problem.
Okay.
But 2,4-D is still around. Not the same product, not the problems with dioxin that we had with 2,4-5-T. In the 2,4-D, 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, but really, really interesting herbicides. And the Phenoxy herbicides are auxin inhibitors. They mimic auxins, naturally occurring auxins that are in plants. And so they really just cause the plants to grow themselves to death. Mm-hmm. When you treat and they're systemic. They're mm-hmm. systemic, meaning that if you get a little bit on a plant, it translocates throughout the whole plant. Doesn't immediately kill the plant, but over a period of 2 or 3 weeks maybe, the plant will start to go down and mm-hmm. you'll start to see symptoms of curling downward growth. Yeah. It's actually cell division, rapid cell division. The plant is actually growing itself to death. And very safe. As far as mammalian toxicity is concerned, safe for around humans, but it's pretty deadly on mostly broadleaf plants.
Right, right.
That's 2,4-D.
That's 2,4-D. What mm-hmm. about dicamba?
Dicamba, it's a benzoic acid. Mm-hmm. It's also in the Phenoxy herbicide family and works exactly the same way. It's an auxin, type inhibitor, and it causes, or it mimics the naturally occurring auxin that's in a plant. And basically causes very similar symptoms, a lot more leaf cupping as the leaf is growing and it will cup. With 2,4-D, you have stem elongation and like a tomato plant may go up and around and back up again and look like
twisting.
Kind of spaghetti, something like that.
Yeah.
But and there's different salts of dicamba. I know in the last couple of years, BASF and Monsanto have released, and also DuPont have released a less volatile form of dicamba. A lot of dicamba and 2,4-D are present in a lot of lawn chemicals, but read that label.
Yeah, sure.
Do not apply any of these Phenoxy herbicides when the wind's blowing 15 miles an hour and you have neighbors next door mm-hmm. with broadleaf. Remember, it kills broadleaf weeds.
And most of your
it
plants
also kills broadleaf
leaves.
Flowers and
That's
broadleaf
right.
shrubs,
That's
and
right.
it can damage broadleaf trees.
Mm-hmm.
So, and also high temperatures.
That's right.
If it's during really hot conditions, don't need to use it. And you don't need to use it when there's a temperature inversion, when there's no wind.
Mm-hmm.
When there's absolutely no wind right about sundown, when fog's kind of hanging out there, well, that's kind of what some of these herbicides do.
It just hovers.
Especially the older formulations, which the older formulations of dicamba are what are the dicambas that are present in all of the lawn materials. Only the agricultural industry mm-hmm. has access now at this point to the newer low volatile forms.
Okay.
They're restricted use pesticides.
That's right.
They've been, by EPA has declared them to be restricted use pesticides. The older, more volatile forms are not restricted use and any homeowner can buy them. And the only reason they're restricted use is because of their potential to move.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's kind of, we got some work to do there, but if you follow the label, they're really, really good to use in the early spring.
Mm-hmm.
Before a lot of things have greened up, when your target weeds are out there, but the flowers aren't, and
right.
you sure. can use them then. But pay attention to when you are responsible for your drift.
That's right.
It's just like when you're driving a boat, you're responsible for your wake. Well, when you're spraying a pesticide, you're responsible for for wherever that goes if the wind's blowing.
So what about glyphosate? We hear
glyphosate
all the time, right?
Been around since the 70s. Mm-hmm. Developed by Monsanto. Mm-hmm. John Franz discovered in 1970, came on the market in 1974. It is also a systemic, mm-hmm. non-selective herbicide. The phenoxies are somewhat selective in that they kill broadleaf weeds,
right.
or broadleaf plants, and they leave the grasses.
Mm-hmm.
That's why it's so good in lawns,
right.
so good in
grasses.
Pastures,
right.
and things like that. When Roundup, when glyphosate first came out under the trade name of Roundup, it was a non-selective herbicide. It killed anything you put it on. and it did that for a number of years. And then after a time, some weeds began to develop resistance
mm-hmm.
because it was used so much. And a little light bulb went off in somebody's head and said, if we have a weed that has resistance, maybe we can create crops that have resistance. So a brand spanking new
yeah.
technology was developed, Roundup
yep,
ready.
Yep.
Cotton, Roundup Ready soybeans, Roundup Ready corn,
mm-hmm.
plants. You could plant these crops and spray over the top, and it would kill every weed in that crop and leave the crop. And you may only have to do it a couple of times a year,
mm-hmm.
you know, one or two applications. So it drastically reduced the amount of herbicides that had to be applied to a field. It reduced the amount of tillage that had to be done. And but unfortunately, some of those weeds began to
yeah.
that were resistant began
yeah.
to crop up, and so we've had to go back and you have to do things a little different. Now farmers have to use you know, they've along the same lines, they've come up with dicamba tolerant crops,
mm-hmm.
they've come up with 2,4-D tolerant crops, I'm sure there will be others as we go down the road.
I'm sure.
But there's no longer a magic bullet.
Right. Know,
farmers now have to use pre-emergent herbicides, and they have to target. It's kind of like, you know, we tell you to do a homeowner when you have an insect out there, identify what the insect is and then use what, you know, will kill that insect.
Right.
Or to control it. If it needs controlling, it may not need controlling, you know. Glyphosate is one of the most widely used herbicides in the world, and still very widely used. The
yeah.
patent expired, I think, in 2000,
yeah.
and so there are a lot of generic glyphosates out there. And
But again, read the label on that as well.
Read the label. Labels are actually very interesting,
right.
and they tell you, you know, how to use the product, how to dispose of it, what to wear, how to be safe with it. Very, very interesting.
Okay, so the last one, Sethoxydim.
Sethoxydim.
Yeah,
that's under the trade name of Post.
Post.
It's also there's several trade names that homeowners use, but it is a selective post-emergent herbicide that primarily kills grasses. It's just the opposite of the Phenoxy mm-hmm. herbicides. They kill the broadleaves and kill grasses. The Sethoxydim. You will leave the broadleaf and kill grasses.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can actually spray it over the top of like strawberries, soybeans, and things like that, and it won't hurt the broadleaves.
Mm-hmm.
It'll kill the grasses. It's also a systemic,
mm-hmm.
and it takes it a while. The systemics usually take a while to work. You know, glyphosate and most of these systemics may take a week or two. But most of the herbicides that homeowners use are going to be systemic in nature.
Yeah. All right, that's some good stuff. It's a good lesson.
Right. Interesting.
Interesting stuff. All right, and again, always read and follow the label.
Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. To find out more information on this topic, just click on the familyplotgarden.com link in the description.